All right, everybody, welcome to the last SmackDown Sunday of November. Sad that the Texans don't have a game today, but I have an opportunity to watch other football games, whether on a Sunday, Monday, or Thursday. Right now, I'm watching the Saints versus the Broncos, and the Saints are killing it. 24-3. I'm not sure Drew Brees is playing right now, but if he isn't, then the Saints are killing it right now without the presence of Drew Brees. Well, the Texans deserve this week off because they already played two games last week. One last Sunday, taking on the Patriots, and one on Thanksgiving against the Lions, and they won them both. So the Texans definitely deserves this week off before they take on the Colts next Sunday. Let's go ahead and reminisce the good old days of wrestling from the good old Attitude Era. About a lethal strap match that aired on this day 19 years ago on the November 29th, 2001 edition of SmackDown. A lethal strap match between NXT General Manager William Regal versus my boy, the toughest SOB of the WWE, the Bionic Redneck, the host of Broken Skull Sessions, the Texas Rattlesnake, and WWE Hall of Famer, who has a birthday next month, along with Trish Stratus, DMX, Christina Aguilera, J.O. Felony, and Rob Van Dam, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Low blow. Stone Cold Steve Austin wins the strap match against William Regal.
Payback from the Thanksgiving Day 2001 edition of SmackDown, where Stone Cold got jumped by the Dudley Boys, William Regal, Christian, and Test. Man, that was a good match. I'm glad Stone Cold won that. Now, I have a special announcement before I close this Attitude Era rant out. Since I have no more video games to review this year, I'm going to reveal all the Attitude Era rants I got coming for the month of December, between this Thursday, December 3rd, and December 27th. Starting on December 3rd, the first Throwback Thursday of December, 19 years of The Rock and Trish Stratus versus Vince McMahon and Kurt Angle. Friday, December 4th, 20 years of a backstage brawl between The Rock, The Undertaker, Kurt Angle, Rikishi, Stone Cold Steve Austin, and Triple H. Next Sunday, December 6th, 19 years of The Rock and Trish Stratus humiliating Vince McMahon. Next Monday, December 7th, which is my boy Serge Dragon's birthday, 20 years of the Dudley Boys joining the Right to Censor. December 9th, highlights from the 2001 Vengeance pay-per-view. December 10th, 19 years of Stone Cold Steve Austin versus Chris Jericho in a steel cage for the Undisputed Championship. December 13th, a Green Frog grocery store brawl between Booker T and Stone Cold Steve Austin. December 17th, 19 years of Stone Cold Steve Austin and Booker T at church. December 18th, 20 years of Stone Cold Steve Austin on his birthday versus William Regal. Sunday, December 20th, 5 days before Christmas, 19 years of The Rock versus Test and Booker T versus Stone Cold Steve Austin in a First Blood match. Christmas Eve, 19 years of Ric Flair's Christmas party. Then I'll show y'all the main event, a triple threat match for the Undisputed Championship between Chris Jericho, The Rock, and Kurt Angle. Christmas Day, 20 years of Stone Cold Steve Austin versus Kane. And my last Attitude Era rant of 2020, December 27th, 19 years of Stone Cold Steve Austin saving The Rock from Booker T and the Big Boss Man. That wraps up my Attitude Era rant, reminiscing 19 years of a lethal strap match between William Regal and Stone Cold from the November 29th, 2001 edition of SmackDown. If you're new to my YouTube, hit subscribe if you like the content and hit that notification bell for my next Attitude Era rant. If you're not new, thumbs up if you liked the video, thumbs down if you didn't, leave your comment down below. Appreciate you watching on my Instagram, IGTV. For my YouTube subscribers, I'll catch you tomorrow celebrating the 50th birthday of our beloved Black Power Ranger, Walter Emmanuel Jones. Don't follow your dreams, chase them. Peace. If you smell what The Rock is cooking. And that's the bottom line, 'cause Stone Cold said so. Thank you.